Amid the apparent rift within the ruling party, Malacanang insists Senator Manny Pacquiao remains an ally of the president. Joining us now is PDP-Laban Executive Director Ronwald Munsayak. Good morning to you, Mr. Munsayak.
Magandang umaga, Ma'am Karen, and to your millions and millions of viewers.
All right, diretsuhin na natin. Mananatili ba si Manny Pacquiao sa PDP-Laban pagkatapos ng ginawa nila?
Yes, ma'am. In fact, kausap ko po si Senator Manny last night at wala talaga siyang intention to leave the party kasi ganyan po talaga si Sir Manny. Pag yan pumasok sa isang responsibilidad, tatayuan niya po yan hanggang sa pinakadulo. And also, we've been doing our consultations with our grassroots leaders and our party mates all over the country. By the way, we are a 100,000 strong. They are all very confident and very happy so far with the leadership of Senator Manny Pacquiao as party president.
Okay, so if Manny is staying in PDP-Laban, does he have conditions? Number one, there will be a national council meeting where, according to Attorney Raul Lambino, Manny Pacquiao was only acting president and members will have to vote for a new president. So there is a possibility that they may vote for someone else.
Yes, ma'am. But to answer Secretary Lambina's statement, we actually are doing away with the term acting because in reality, all of us are acting. In probably the past 10 years, we have yet to convene our National Council and our National Assembly because before President Duterte became president, we were really a very small party. Mm-hmm. But now that we have exploded to more than 100,000, we believe that it is now the right time to probably call the National Council. But first, we have to follow the right process because, ma'am, we are actually questioning the calling of the National Council meeting that was done 2 days ago because we believe that it violated our constitution. Wherein,
but Attorney Lambino said that the chairman, the president himself, can call for a National Council meeting.
Yes, that's true, ma'am. But the party chairman must work with the party president. So our chairman, President Digong, must work together with our party president, Manny Pacquiao, so that they can fix agenda and then they will instruct our secretary general to convene the National Council.
And that is clear in your bylaws.
Yes, ma'am, it's crystal clear. But what happened was that we just learned that the authority to call and organize the National Council was given to Secretary Kuser, vice chairman, by President Digong. So there's nothing wrong with calling on the National Council, but ang request lang po namin is sana po masunod lang po yung tamang proseso.
Oo. So what is Manny Pacquiao left with, considering if it's the party chairman himself, who is the president of the country, is the one violating your own bylaws?
Hindi naman siguro, ma'am. Baka lang po hindi po nabasa ng ibang mga kasamahan natin yung proper way of convening a National Council. And so to remedy this, we actually are requesting a meeting with our party chairman so that both the top leaders of our party can sit down, fix agenda, and then we can properly call and convene the real and legal National Council.
Okay, so what if President Duterte refuses to see Senator Manny?
I doubt, ma'am, if President Duterte will refuse to see Senator Manny because just like as what Malacanang said, they still see Senator Manny as their ally. Malacanang even said that idol po ni Pangulong Digong si Senator Manny sa larangan.
But hypothetically, let's say he doesn't get the meeting.
Then, ma'am, we will have to go back to, we will have to consult our leaders on what will be our next course of action.
Mm-mm. So is it right, Ron, that Senator Manny will stay in a PDP-Laban only if he gets a dialogue with President Duterte, the party chairman? Is that a condition to him staying?
Actually, Ma'am Karen, wala pong conditions. Basing it on our conversation last night, Senator Manny is more than willing to really stay in the party. He wants to lead the party. And in fairness to Senator Manny, when he read the constitution bylaws and studied about his history of the party, he fell in love with the party. And by the way, Senator Manny has been with the party since 2012.
Mm-mm. Okay, but will Senator Manny Pacquiao stay with the party even if he is not the party In other words, even if he is not the one chosen either by the president or the party to run for president in 2022.
I wouldn't want to preempt Senator Manny, but I believe he joined the party for its principles and ideology. So, and he respects the rules of the party. So, if the National Assembly decides to elect for a new set of officers, he will definitely respect that. And us as party members must respect that. But again, ma'am, before we call on the National Council and the Assembly, we must first follow the proper process of doing so.
So you're making it very clear, but there seems to be a move to kick him out as president.
Well, ma'am, in fairness to Secretary Cusi and the other party officers, we wouldn't want to think of it that way. That's why we are requesting for a meeting with our chairman, President Digong, so that President Digong, Senator Manny Pacquiao, can sit down and maybe iron out whatever misunderstandings we have. And Vice Chairman Cusi is more than welcome to join that meeting.
Okay. Does Senator Manny Pacquiao even agree with a resolution that was passed by PDP-Laban urging President Duterte to run for vice president in 2022? In principle, does he agree with that?
Senator Manny Pacquiao has always been a supporter of President Duterte. He has always been an ally of our chairman. But we are, Ma'am Karen, we are actually questioning the calling of the National Council because the proper procedures were not followed. So anything that follows, the outcome of that the council is already questionable. So so Ma'am Karen, basically we just want to move forward. Again, we are reiterating our request sa aming mahal ng party chairman, President Duterte, if he has time, although we know that he's very busy, maybe if he can allot an hour of his time so that we can all, so that both of them can sit down so that we can properly call on the National Council meeting.
Has Senator Manny Pacquiao personally reached out to the president?
Yes, ma'am. We have written the president letters.
And?
As he responded? As of this morning, wala po pong response, but we totally understand because the president is very, very busy. Nakakapagod po talaga magpatakbo ng isang bansa, lalo na ngayon sa pandemya.
Okay. So it seems to me that as much as possible, the way you're sounding is Senator Manny Pacquiao would like to stay with PDP-Laban.
Definitely, ma'am, until the very end.
So even if his powers are clipped, his influence is clipped, the possibility of him running for 2022 is taken away by the party, he will stay with PDP-Laban instead of putting up his own party and running his own campaign. Is that what you're saying?
I believe the senator joined the party not because he wants to be an officer, but when he joined the party as an ordinary member. Us party mates, Senator Pimentel and the other leaders of the party, saw the massive potential of Senator Pacquiao leading the PDP-Laban. That's why we all agreed to make him party leader as party president. And with regards to whatever plans he has this coming 2022, marami pong nagsasabi na magaling
umalis ka na.
Hindi po, marami nagsasabi na malakas na kandidato, magaling po, pwedeng leader ng bansa. Pero if we talk to Senator Manny Pacquiao, he would always tell us, Ron and other leaders, saka na muna ng politika. Napakaraming problema pa na bansa. Meaning, maraming may sakit, maraming naghihirap, at ngayon po, may mga rotating brownouts pa po tayo.
All right. Well, I guess on that note, why isn't the senator speaking himself?
Well,
regarding the issue.
Right now, Ma'am, Senator Manny Pacquiao has been extremely busy with his Senate work. It's the last week of Senate session now, so he's really preparing for privileged speeches, filing bills, resos, hearings, and also he's also training. He started his high-intensity training last week. And when Senator Manny Pacquiao focuses on one thing, he really is focused. But at the end of the day, he meets with us party leaders and then he discusses ano na bang mga updates sa party. So we update him and then he gives us instructions. Because Ma'am Karen, also just to add, talagang si Senator Manny, kaya po talaga siya napupursigo din sa boxing niya, sa boxing career niya. Kasi dito po talaga nanggagaling yung mga tulong niya sa mga tao. We all know how Senator Manny helps a lot of people, yung mga libreng pabahay, mga pagkain na pinamimigay niya, mga gamot. Ito po ay galing sa personal na bulsa niya. Kaya pagdating po talaga sa boxing, sabi niya, ito yung priority niya sa ngayon.
Okay, I get that, but I think my last question would be, do you think that Senator Manny would still have, in a way, credibility or influence to be president of a party when, number one, when he called for a boycott of the PDP-Laban National Assembly, no less than his colleagues, Senator Bato and Senator Tolentino, ignored him? So those are already his colleagues, right? Number two, he's going to be staying in a party wherein clearly no less than the vice chairman, Alfonso Cusi himself, has continued the meeting despite the president saying, meaning Manny, don't do the meeting. So ang tanong lang, pangkaraniwang tanong ng tao, ano pang babalikan niya?
Okay, ma'am. First, ma'am, yung nangyari pong National Council meeting 2 days ago were attended by a little more than 100 of our PDP-Laban members. And kasi po, sa paniniwala nila, meron pong bas-bas ito ni Chairman President Igong. So they attended. But let us not forget, Senator Manny Pacquiao also has the support of the other 99,900 grassroots party leaders all over the country.
Uh-oh.
So yung nag-attend po, yes, they are Senator Manny's colleagues, they are our respected officials, but again, we have more than 100,000 grassroots leaders and they all support Senator Manny Pacquiao. So again, si Sir Manny coming, lalo na nanggaling sa mahirap na estado ng buhay, mas yun ang mga tinitingnan niya. But again, but still, he has to work with the party system. So he has requested for a meeting with our honorable chairman. And sana po makapag-upo sila. And again, Vice Chairman Cusi is more than welcome to join para ma-iron out na po natin kung anumang maliliit na misunderstanding meron tayo.
So yun ang malinaw, Ron. What you're saying is, even if more than 100 attended that meeting, don't underestimate Senator Manny's support with the PDP-Laban grassroots level because it's in the thousands.
100,000, ma'am.
That's what you're saying,
yes,
right?
Ma'am.
Okay. On that note, well, we hope to hear from Senator Manny regarding this soon. But thank you so much, Ron, for joining us this morning. Thank you.
Maraming salamat, ma'am. Bye-bye.
Okay, God bless you.